focus on the verbs in each sentence that I provided for you. Are you ready? Together, read after me. I get up at 7:30 a.m. I get up at 7:30 a.m. Nobita gets up at 7:30 a.m. Nobita gets up at 7:30 a.m. My brother and I go to school. My brother and I go to school. My cat goes to school. My cat goes to school. I study a lot. I study a lot. Hazel studies a lot. Hazel studies a lot. Jim and Kate have breakfast. Jim and Kate have breakfast. He has breakfast. He has breakfast. Can you actually see the difference between the verbs already? In today's lesson, we are talking about simple present. When we are writing sentences in simple present, we will always have to be very focused on the subject pronouns. And what are these subject pronouns? They are he, she, it, they, we, I, you. Even though you don't come across directly with the subject pronouns in every sentence, however, you will have to know that if there is a name given at the beginning of the sentence, it is also considered as a pronoun. He, she, it, they, we, are, you are the basic subject pronouns. Well, we don't always write sentences with he, she, it, they, we, are, you. We can give names. And these names are Nobita, Hazel, my cat, Jim and Kate, my brother and I. So whenever you notice that the names used in the sentence apply with the same principle here that I show on this table, it means that it refers to the subject pronoun that we are talking about. He refers to a male. Nobita is a name of a male. So we can also use he. Hazel is a name of a female. Hence, we can use the subject pronoun she. My cat is a non-human thing. And in terms of quantity, it is only one. Therefore, we can use it. Whereby for Jim and Kate, for anything that is more than one, we will have to use they. Whereby for we, any pronoun that end with the keyword and I, we will have to use we as the subject pronoun. And last but not least, I and you. These subject pronouns are the main factor that contribute to the differences of the verbs that you read from the sentences just now. Remember, pupils, whenever we are using the subject pronoun he, she, and it, the verb, they must have s. However, not every verb when meets subject pronoun, we have to put s at the back. We can also put ies, es, or have or has. Why is that so? Ies is only used for any verb that end with a letter y. Therefore, we have to change to ies if the verb meets one of these subject pronoun. Whereby for es, it is for most of the verb that end with the letter O, then we would have to go for ES if the verb meets the subject pronoun he, she, or it, or any names that apply to the subject pronoun he, she, it. On the other hand, verbs that meet the subject pronoun they, we, are, you, there is no S at the back. It will remain in its base form. And last but not least, these are the ideas.
Now, take out your worksheets module and turn to page 8, exercise 1. Compare the sentences, then match A to D with spelling rules 1 to 4. You have to read all sentences from A to D, and then read the rules from 1 to 4 first. Read all sentences together, class. Sentence A. I study a lot. Her older daughter studies. Sentence B. We have breakfast at 7:30 a.m. He has breakfast. Sentence C. My brother and I go to school. He goes to work. Sentence D. I get up at 7 a.m. Noel gets up at 4:45 a.m. Let's read all the rules. We use the present simple when we talk about facts and routines. The he, she, and it forms N with S. Rule number 1. Add S to most verbs. For example, play, place. Rule number 2. Add ES when a verb ends with O, SH, CH, or X. Rule number 3. Minus Y and add IES when a verb ends with a consonant Y. Rule number 4. The third person of have is has. You have to focus on the subject pronouns and the verbs in every sentence. We are going to look at the subject pronouns first. Let's look at sentence A. The subject pronoun is I and also her older daughter. How about sentence B? Can you tell me which is the subject pronoun? Yes, we and also he. Sentence C. Which is the subject pronoun? My brother and I go to school. Is it my brother or I or my brother and I? Yes, the subject pronoun is my brother and I. And then the word he is the subject pronoun for the next sentence. The last sentence, sentence D. I get up at 7 a.m. Noel gets up at 4:45 a.m. Which is the subject pronoun of these sentences? Yes, it is I and the word Noel. Class, please underline the subject pronouns in all sentences. Underline, gariskan semua subject pronouns di dalam setiap ayat. Now, let's look at the verbs in every sentences. Sentence A. I study a lot. Her older daughter studies. The word study and studies are the verbs for these sentences. Let's look at sentence B. Can you tell me which is the verb? Yes, the word have and has. Sentence C, go and goes. And the last one, sentence D, get up and gets up. For verbs, you have to circle it. Bulatkan semua verbs. Now, we are going to choose the rules for each sentence. For example, sentence A. I study a lot. Her older daughter studies. Class, what happened to the word study and studies? What is the difference? Yes, huruf Y-nya telah dibuang dan digantikan dengan IES. Lihat perbezaannya. Remember, you have to compare. Bermaksud anda perlu membezakan verb ini. Huruf Y pada study telah dibuang dan digantikan dengan IES. Jadi murid-murid, kita tengok semua rules yang ada. Which rule is suitable for sentence A? Look at rule 1. Add S to most verbs. For example, play, plays. Tambahkan S kepada kebanyakan verbs. Tambahkan S kepada kebanyakan kata kerja. Contohnya, play, plays. Alright? Sekarang kita tengok rule yang kedua. Add ES when a verb ends with O, SH, CH or X. Tambahkan huruf ES jika verb berakhir dengan huruf O, SH, CH ataupun X. Mari tengok rule ketiga. Minus Y and add IES when a verb ends with a consonant Y. Tolak. Minus adalah tolak dan tambahkan pula dengan IES. Jika verb berakhir dengan huruf Y, anda perlu buang Y itu dan gantikan dengan huruf IES. Dan untuk rule keempat, ini tentang third person, orang ketiga. Subject pronoun-nya adalah orang ketiga, bukan saya, bukan awak, tapi orang lain. Perlu digantikan dengan has. Alright, jadi kita tengok contoh sentence A. I study a lot, her older daughter studies. Jadi, rule yang mana yang sesuai untuk sentence A? Lihat, kita tengok semula, huruf Y-nya telah dibuang dan digantikan dengan IES. Jadi, rule yang sesuai adalah rule yang ketiga. Anak-anak, you have to continue with sentence B to D by yourself. Remember, you have to look at the verb. Verbnya adalah perkataan yang awak dah bulatkan tadi. Yang ini have, dia jadi has. I, jadi goes. Get up, dia jadi gets up. So, kena suaikan. Nah, suaikan di sini yang mana satu rule-nya. Now, let's move on to exercise 2. Choose the correct verbs. You have to refer to the subject pronouns. After you have read all the sentences, you have to analyze the subject pronouns and then you will be able to choose the correct verb. Class, which is the subject pronouns in the sentences? You must underline all subject pronouns. Look at sentence 1. Read the sentence. You go or goes to bed at 9:30 p.m. Which is the subject pronoun? Yes, the word you is the subject pronoun. Look at sentence 2. My parents relaxes or relax in the evening. Which is the subject pronouns class? The word my parents. How about number 3? My teacher speaks or speak 4 languages. The word my teacher is the subject pronoun. Now class, continue until number 15. The subject pronouns for number 5 is I. Number 6 is my sister. Number 7 is the old man. And number 8 is my siblings. Remember, you have to continue to underline the subject pronouns until number 15. Let's choose the correct verb. Alright. To choose the verb, you have to refer to the subject pronouns. Remember, I have already told you to copy these notes here in your English one or at the back of your Unit 2 worksheets module. Alright, now, in the table here, we have the subject pronouns, the verbs, and ideas. Now, based on the table, look at sentence 1 again. You go or goes to bed at 9:30 p.m. Our subject pronoun here is you. Subject pronoun kita untuk ayat 1 adalah you. Sekarang, lihat pada jadual yang diberi, subject pronoun, you, it's here. Ini berdasarkan jadual ini, you berada di subject pronouns dan apakah verb yang sesuai? What is the correct verb? Look at the verbs column here. We have get, study, go and have. Ini hanyalah contoh berdasarkan contoh yang diberi dan kebetulan sama dengan soalannya, kita ada perkataan go. Jadi untuk nombor 1, jawapannya adalah go. You go to bed at 9:30 p.m. Untuk jawapannya, sila bulatkan verb. Bulatkan kata kerja yang betul. So ayatnya akan jadi you go to bed at 9:30 p.m. Now, look at sentence 2. My parents relaxes or relax in the evening. My parents. Kita tiada perkataan my parents di dalam jadual yang diberi. Jadi, lihat semula perkataan my parents. My parents, kita ada S di sini bermakna ia dilakukan oleh ramai. Kedua-dua ibu bapa. Parents adalah ibu dan ayah. Lihat kumpulan bawah, kumpulan plural. Lebih daripada seorang, kita sebut sebagai plural. Okay, bila lebih daripada seorang, okay, my parents, kita tak perlu tambahkan dengan S. Lihat verb yang diberi. Get, study, go, have. Okay, kerana ia dilakukan oleh lebih daripada seorang, they ataupun mereka, we ataupun kami, verbnya tak perlu ditambah dengan s. Jadi lihat pilihan jawapan yang diberi, relaxes and relax. Jadi yang manakah jawapan yang betul untuk ayat kedua? Which is the correct verb? My parents. Perlu tambah es ataupun tak perlu? Okay, so jawapannya adalah relax. Kerana ia dilakukan oleh dua orang, tak perlu ditambahkan dengan S. Ataupun untuk konteks perkataan relax, kita tak perlu tambahkan dengan ES. Look at sentence 3. My teacher speaks or speak 4 languages. My teacher ini seorang ataupun ramai? My teachers barulah ramai. Sekarang perkataannya adalah my teacher. So my teacher seorang speaks ataupun speak. Bila dia dilakukan oleh seorang, singular. Singular kita lihat kumpulan yang atas. Okay, kumpulan yang sebelah atas, lihat contoh verbs yang diberi, ditambah dengan S, ataupun ditambah dengan IES, ataupun ditambah dengan ES, ataupun have bertukar sebagai has. Okay, so tengok, my teacher seorang, berlaku pertambahan di hujung perkataan verb di sini. So, perkataan speaks dengan speak. Yang mana satu yang berlaku pertambahan? Yes, of course. The answer is speaks. Okay, kerana my teacher seorang, perkataan speak ini perlu ada S. My teacher speaks 4 languages. Move on to number 4. Our English class. Satu kelas bahasa Inggeris ataupun banyak kelas bahasa Inggeris di sini. Okay, kerana kelas hanyalah satu, so verb kita adalah finish ataupun finishes. Ingat, bila dia satu, kena tengok kumpulan yang atas dan bila kumpulan yang atas berlaku pertambahan. Okay, bila dia dilakukan oleh seorang, kita perlu tambahkan dengan S ataupun buang Y jadi IES ataupun tambah dengan ES ataupun has. Okay, so kerana seorang, jawapan kita untuk number 4 adalah finishes. Now, number 5, I has or have lunch at home. Okay, tengok pada jadual, kita ada perkataan I di sini sebagai subject pronoun. So, dah tentulah jawapannya adalah have. Alright, number 6, my sister. My sister ni seorang ke ramai? Okay, it is singular, my sister. So, studies or study? Can you give me the answer? So, kerana dia seorang, lihat di sini. Okay, kebetulan juga ada perkataan studies. So, jawapannya adalah my sister studies at the weekend. Class, you have to continue this exercise until number 15. Okay, please refer to the table and then based on the subject pronouns, choose which is the correct verbs for all sentences. Let's move on to exercise 3. Pronunciation. Third person, S. Listen to the third person form of the verbs and repeat. Color the verbs that ends with an S sounds.
Language focus. Exercise 3. 1. Relaxes. 2. Goes. 3. Watches. 4. Eats. 5. Speaks. 6. Likes. 7. Starts. 8. Finishes. 9. Washes. 10. Studies. Unit 2. Language focus. Exercise 3. 1. Relaxes. 2. Goes. 3. Watches. 4. Eats. 5. Speaks. 6. Likes. 7. Starts. 8. Finishes. 9. Washes. 10. Studies.